explanation of the book titled by Islam Q&A. ومعنا اليوم آخر أركان الإيمان. And today we are going through the last pillar of إيمان. وهو الإيمان بالقدر خيره وشره. إيمان بالقدر خيره وشره. And it is believing in the قدر. قدر the good of it and the bad of it, that it is all from Allah. ومعنى القدر يقال القدر ويقال القضاء. The meaning of القدر it is said linguistically القدر and القضاء. والعلماء مختلفون في معنى القضاء والقدر. And the scholars have different opinions in the meaning of or the explanation of قضاء and قدر. بعضهم قال القدر هو ما كتب في اللوح المحفوظ قبل خلق السماوات والأرض بخمسين ألف سنة كما في الحديث عند مسلم. Some of the scholars say that the قضاء the قدر is what is written in the preserved book 50,000 years before the heavens and earth were created as in the hadith in Sahih Muslim. والقضاء قالوا هو ما يأمر به الله الملائكة من إيقاعه على عباده كل لحظة من لحظات حياتهم. And the قضاء is what Allah commands the angels with to deliver to the creation of Allah in every single moment of their life. وبعضهم قال العكس. And some others said it is the opposite. يعني القضاء ما كتب والقدر ما يرى. Meaning that the قضاء is what is written in the preserved book and the قدر is what you see happening. لكن لا يضر أيا كان المعنى فالمقصود أنه كل شيء قد كتب في اللوح المحفوظ. But this does not make any difference because the meaning is that everything is written in the preserved book. كما قال الله عز وجل في كتابه العزيز. As Allah said in his noble book كما في سورة الحديد الآية 22 as in سورة الحديد آية 22 قال الله تعالى ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في السماء ولا في أنفسكم ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها إن ذلك على الله يسير. No disaster strikes upon the earth or among yourselves except that it is in a register, meaning in the preserved slate or اللوح المحفوظ. Before we bring it into being, indeed, that for Allah is easy. والله عز وجل خلق كل شيء وقدره تقديرا، كما قال سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الفرقان في الآية الثانية: أن الله created everything، يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى gave it its determination. As Allah Ta'ala said in Ayah 2 of Surah Al-Furqan, الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض ولم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك وخلق كل شيء فقدره تقديرا. He, Allah, to whom belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth, and who has not taken a son and has not had a partner in dominion, and has created each thing and determined it with precise determination. والله عز وجل قدر الأقدار بحكمته البالغة. أن الله سبحانه وتعالى decreed the destinies by his perfect wisdom. وهو سبحانه وتعالى وحده الذي يعلم ما كان وما يكون وما لم يكن لو كان كيف يكون. And he, Allah alone, knows what was and what never happened, and that which never happened, if it happens, how would it be and how it will happen? That is for Allah alone. والإيمان بالقدر يعني التصديق الجازم بعلم الله تعالى بالأشياء قبل كونها. And faith in القدر, believing in القدر, is the awareness, the unwavering affirmation that Allah, the Most High, has knowledge of things before they exist. وكتابته لها في اللوح المحفوظ. And that he wrote them in the reserved book. ومشيئته لوقوعها. And that he willed that they occur. وخلقه وإيجاده لها, and that he created them and made them to into being. فهذه أربعة أركان للإيمان بالقدر. So these are four pillars of believing in القدر. من أخل بواحدة فسد إيمانه كله. He whoever fail to have one of them, then his faith, all of it, is invalid. نعيدها مرتبة. So we repeat it in order. أركان الإيمان بالقدر, the pillars of believing in القدر, أربعة, four. الأول, التصديق الجازم بعلم الله تعالى للأشياء قبل كونها. The first is unwavering affirmation that Allah, the Most High, has knowledge of things before they exist. أو نقول الأول، الأول نعم هذا هو الأول علمه بها. الثاني كتابته لها في اللوح المحفوظ. Second pillar is that he wrote them in the preserved tablet, لوح المحفوظ. كما في الحديث في صحيح مسلم إن الله خلق أول ما خلق القلم. As in the hadith in Sahih Muslim that Allah created the first of what he created, the pen. فقال له اكتب. Then Allah commanded it, saying, write. فقال القلم ما اكتب. The pen said, what should I write? قال اكتب ما هو كائن إلى قيام الساعة. Allah Ta'ala said to the pen, write that which is going to exist until the existence of the hour. والقلم لا يعلم، لكن الله عز وجل في تلك اللحظة جعله يعلم كل شيء فكتبه وجرى وكتب. And the pen does not know anything, but Allah made him to know everything that time. So the pen ran and wrote. والقلم إنما يكتب ما يريد من يمسك به. And the pen would only write that which the holder of it wants. فأنت تمسك القلم, so you hold the pen and write. لكن ذلك القلم لم يكن ثم ممسك له. But that pen had no one to hold it. لكن جرى هو بنفسه من ساعته. فكتب كل شيء. But it ran by itself. In that moment, immediately and wrote everything. بأمر الله, by the command of Allah, الذي إذا أراد شيئا إنما يقول له كن فيكون. He Allah, the one who whenever wants anything, he Allah just say to it be and it be. فكتب القلم كل شيء. So the pen wrote everything. إذن الركن الثاني الإيمان بكتابة القدر في اللوح المحفوظ. So the second pillar is the affirmation that Allah had written the qadr of everything. الثالث المشيئة, مشيئة الله لهذا القدر أن يقع, أن يحدث, أن يخرج للوجود الكون. The third is that the will of Allah for that what is written in the tablet to exist, to be a being. لأنه لو لم يشأ الله عز وجل له أن يكون لا يكون. Because if Allah did not will for it to be, it cannot be. كما قال الشافعي رحمه الله, as the Imam الشافعي رحمه الله said, ما شئت كان وإن لم أشأ, وما شئت إن لم تشأ لم يكن. Imam الشافعي said, what you owe Allah will, that what is going to exist. even if I don't will it, if I don't want it to exist, even if I don't want it to exist. ما شئت كان وإن لم أشأ وما شئت and whatever I will إن لم تشأ لم يكن. If you don't will it to happen, it will never happen. كما قال الله عز وجل, as what Allah تعالى said, في سورة الإنسان وفي سورة التكوير. إن سورة الإنسان إن سورة تكوير, في سورة الإنسان في الآية 30 منها ما قبل الأخيرة, in آية number 30 which is the one before last, قال سبحانه وتعالى وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء الله إن الله كان عليما حكيما. And you do not will except that Allah wills. Indeed, Allah is ever knowing and wise. ما معنى هذا وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء, أي كل ما شئتموه أنتم لن يكون إلا أن يشاء الله له أن يكون. What does that mean? That means whatever you or creation will cannot exist until Allah the Almighty wills it. Until Allah the Almighty wills it. وقد فسر هذه المشيئة الله سبحانه وتعالى في الآية الأخيرة من سورة الإنسان. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى explained and interpreted this will in the following ayah, the last ayah of Surah Al-Insan. قال تعالى يدخل من يشاء في رحمته والظالمين أعد لهم عذابا أليما. He admits whom he wills into his mercy, but the wrongdoers he has prepared for them a painful punishment. وفي التكوير قال سبحانه وتعالى, as in Surah Al-Takwir, Allah the Almighty said في آخر آية منها, in the last ayah of it, قال وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء الله رب العالمين. And you do not will except that Allah wills, Lord of the worlds. ما معنى هذا؟ أي كلما شئتم أن يقع فإنه لن يقع إلا أن يشاء الله له أن يقع. Meaning, all that which you will to exist or to happen would not happen except if Allah wills it to happen. وبيّن سبحانه وتعالى ذلك أيضا في مواضع عدة من كتابه. أن الله the Almighty said or explained this in many different verses in his book. كما قال سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الأنفال, as Allah تعالى said in سورة الأنفال في الآية 67, as in آية 76, تريدون عرض الدنيا والله يريد الآخرة والله عزيز حكيم. تريدون عرض الدنيا, you meaning some of the Muslims, some of the Sahaba, desire the commodities of this world, meaning the material benefit such as the ransom paid for prisoners, war prisoners. This is in Badr, the Battle of Badr. تريدون عرض الدنيا. You desire the commodities of this world. والله يريد الآخرة. But Allah desire for you thereafter. ما معنى؟ معنى الأجر. Meaning the reward. والآيات في هذا كثيرة. And the verses of the Quran in this are so many. فهم القدر يريح البشر. فهم القدر يريح البشر. Understanding the qadr will make people relax. مر الحسن البصري على شاب يجلس على صخرة حزينا. الحسن البصري, one of the great scholars of the students of the Sahaba, passed by a young man sitting on a rock in a very sad state. فقال له فيما الحزن. He asked him, what is this sadness for? أهو في شيء أراده الله أن يكون فلم يكن. Is it for something that Allah willed it to happen but it didn't happen? قال الشاب, لا, لا يمكن لشيء أراده الله أن يكون إلا أن يكون. He said, no, there is nothing that Allah wills it to happen but it will happen. قال أهو أفي شيء لم يرده الله أن يكون فكان. He asked him again, is it something that Allah did not want it to happen but it happened? قال لا, لا يكون, لا يمكن لشيء لم يرده الله أن يكون فيكون. He said, no, there is nothing that Allah does not want it to does not will it to happen. It can happen. It's impossible. فقال له إذن فيما الحزن. So he said to him, then for what is your sadness? والمعنى and the meaning, أنه ما دامت الأمور بيد الله ففيما تحزن على ما فات أو ما لم أو ما وقع عليك من أذى. So what for you are sad? For something you missed or calamity fall on you. فالإيمان بالقدر يريح البشر. Believing أو فهم القدر يريح البشر. Understanding the قدر brings relax to the people. وأما ثمرات الإيمان بالقدر فهي كثيرة جدا. هذه منها الراحة والسكينة. As for the fruits of believing in the qadr are so many, so huge. This is one of them. Relaxation. Taking matters easy. ومن ثمرات الإيمان بالقدر, and from the fruits of the belief in the qadr, صدق التوكل على الله. لأن الإيمان بالقدر لا يكون مع عدم التوكل الصحيح. Firstly, true reliance on Allah, the Most High. Because believing in qadr cannot be without relying upon Allah the way it should be. طيب كيف يكون التوكل الصحيح؟ So how correct reliance upon Allah should be? أن تعمل بالأسباب وترضى بالنتائج. That you do your role for anything you want it to happen and then you accept the results. مثلا أردت الولد. Example, you want children. تتزوج. You get married. أما تجلس بدون زواج كيف يأتيك الولد؟ But you remain without marriage, and how can you get children? فإذا تزوجت قد تعطى الولد وقد لا تعطى الولد. فإن أعطيت الولد شكرت وإن لم تعطى الولد صبرت ورضيت. So after marrying, you may be given a child and you may not be given a child. If you are given a child, so you be grateful, you thank Allah. If you are not given a child, you be patient and pleased with the qadar of Allah. With the qadar of Allah. هذا هو التوكل الصحيح والإيمان بالقدر الصحيح. This is the correct reliance upon Allah and believing the, and the correct belief in the qadar. لأن الله هو مسبب الأسباب. Because Allah is the one, because Allah is the one who causes the means for anything to happen. والمزارع إذا أراد أن يزرع في حقله, and the farmer if he wants to يعني farm in his يعني to plant in his farm, لا بد أن يضع البذرة في التربة ويسقيها الماء ويتعاهد. He must put the seed in the soil and water it and look after it. وهي وهذه البذرة قد تنتج وقد لا تنتج. And this seed may grow and may not grow. وإذا أنتجت قد تنتج مطعوما جيدا وقد يكون غير صالح. And if this seed grow up and brought fruit, this fruit might be nice and good or maybe spoiled and not good for eating. دوره أن يضع البذرة ويسقي التربة ويتعاهد الشجرة من الآفات. Your role as a farmer is to plant the seed, water it, and look after it from any defects. وأما الإثمار وجودة الثمار إنما هي من عند الله. As for the fruits and the quality of fruits is only from Allah. ولهذا قال سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الواقعة, that's what Allah تعالى said in سورة الواقعة, أفرأيتم ما تمنون, have you seen that which you emit, meaning the semen, which you contains the which contains the potential for human life. أأنتم تخلقونه أم نحن الخالقون. Is it you who creates it or are we the creators? نحن قدرنا بينكم الموت وما نحن بمسبوقين. We have decreed death among you and we are not to be outdone. على أن نبدل أمثالكم وننشئكم فيما لا تعلمون. In that we will change your likenesses and produce you in that from which you do not know. وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْتُمُ النَّشْأَةَ الْأُولَى فَلَوْلَا تَذَكَّرُ. And you have already known the first creation, so will you not remember? أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَحْرُثُونَ. Have you seen that seed which you sow? أأنتم تزرعونه أم نحن الزارعون? Is it you who makes it grow, or are we the grower? لو نشاء لجعلناه حطاما فظلتم تفكهون. If we will, we could make a dry debris and you would remain in wonder. إنا لمغرمون. Say, indeed we are now in debt. بل نحن محرومون. Rather, we have been deprived. أفرأيتم ما تشربون. Have you seen the water that you drink? أأنتم أنزلتموه من المزن أم نحن المنزلون؟ Is it you who brought it down from the clouds, or is it we who bring it down? لو نشاء جعلناه أجاجا فلولا تشكرون. If we will, we could make it bitter. So why you are not grateful? أفرأيتم النار التي تورون. And have you seen the fire that you ignite? And here the fire does not resemble only the flame. Electricity today is the fire. Any power that gives you light, that gives you heat, is a fire. أفرأيتم النار التي تورون. And have you seen the fire that you ignite? أأنتم أنشأتم شجرتها أم نحن المنشئون؟ Is it you who produced its tree? لأن النار لها شجرة تشتعل منها. كان الإنسان الأول يضرب الحجر بالحجر على نوع من الشجر فيشتعل، ليس كل الشجر يشتعل. Is it you who produced its tree? يعني the fire, there is a tree especially for firing. The first man used to bring two stones and scratch them and they make spark. He scratched them by that tree which the first man know. And when the spark catches on that tree, the tree ignites or makes a fire. Allah says, are we the producer? نحن جعلناها تذكرة ومتاع للمقوين. مسافرين. We have made it a reminder and a provision for the travelers. إذن الإيمان بالقدر هذه نتائجه. هذه طريقته وهذه نتائجه. So, believing in the destiny, the correct way is as described. And these are the fruits of it. ومنها الطمأنينة والرضا بما يجري على العبد كما ذكرنا في قصة الحسن البصري. And from it is tranquility and pleasure with what happens to the worshipper, as we mentioned in the story of الحسن البصري. فلا يتسخط أقدار الله. So he does not show any anger towards the destiny of Allah. إذا مات له محبوب أو فات عليه مطلوب أو حصل عليه مكروه. Whenever a beloved one dies for him or something he liked, he missed, or a disliked thing happened to him. أيضا الثالث الشجاعة والثبات عند مواجهة الأزمات. The third, courage and firmness when confronted with crisis. واستقبال مشاق الحياة بقلب ثابت ويقين صادق. And facing the difficulties of life with a firm heart and truth for certainty. والرابعة عدم إعجاب المرء نفسه عند حصول مراده، لأن حصوله على ذلك إنما هو بقدر الله تعالى وتوفيقه وفضله. And the fourth, the absence of self-amazement when he achieves his goals. That is because his achievement of that is only from the decree of Allah, the Most High. And the success given to him from Allah and his favor for him. أسأل الله بمنه وكرمه أن يجعلني وإياكم جميعا من من فهموا التوحيد وأيقنوا بالقدر حق الإيقان وتوكلوا على الله حق التوكل، إنه سبحانه وتعالى ولي ذلك وقادر عليه. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته شيخنا، بارك الله فيك.
وفيكم بارك الله. هناك أسئلة شيء أو نختم؟
شيخ في سؤال واحد. نعم. The brother asks about the pen. So if the pen has been written, everything's been written إلى يوم القيامة with the pen, is the pen writing now, and how does it connect with in the Isra wal-Mi'raj when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to the furthest point and he heard the writing of the pen?
طيب. The pen, Allah Ta'ala, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith of Jabir in Sahih Muslim describing the Hajj of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم when he finished his tawaf and sa'i of arrival and he stood over on the mountain of Al-Marwa from the low level of the valley. A man called Suraqa ibn Juhshum stood and said, Ya Rasulallah, clarify our religion for us as if we just accepted Islam today. Is it something written and finished, or it is something we just received? Isa Salam said, no, it is something already finished. And then he said, as in the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud, Ibn Abbas, when he said to him, oh lad, I am teaching you words. And then he said, safeguard Allah and his boundaries, his commands and his forbiddings. Allah will safeguard you in calamities and etc. At the end of the hadith, he said to him, pens are lifted and ink is dried, meaning no more writing. It is called preserved book. In English, what does the word preserved mean? Saved. No one sees what is in there. Only Allah. What the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard when he was ascended to the heavens, he heard sarir al-aqlam, not qalam, al-aqlam. He heard the sound made by the movement of the pins, not pen. The command of Allah 50,000 years before creating the heavens and earth was to a pen, not pens, a pen. Those pens are the pens in the hands of the angels who are writing in sub-tablets what Allah commands them to may to convey to the creation or to make creation do or something like that. And this is what the shayateen climb one over the other to reach the heavens to hear. It's as the Ibn Abbas said, the day by day qadr, because the qadr is of four times. Universal Qadr that happens only, يعني, that was in the Lawh al-Mahfuz, happens only in the life. يعني. And the second is annual. And the third is the third is in the womb. In the womb. And the fourth is daily. Is daily. So, as Allah Ta'ala said, كل يوم هو في شأن. كل يوم هو في شأن, as in سورة الرحمن. سورة الرحمن. يسأله من في السماوات والأرض, كل يوم هو في شأن. Whoever is within the heavens and the earth asks him, يعني their needs or every day he is in a matter, meaning bringing about a matter. Ibn Abbas said from his shan, from this matter, is that he makes people die, makes people born, makes people get rich, makes people get poor, like that. Day by day affairs of the whole world. It's not happening by itself, automatic, as they say. It's not happening by the will of the angels. No. They wait for the command from Allah, so they write it. This is what the Prophet ﷺ said, Sarir al-Aqlam. There are many pins. The angels on your two shoulders have pins in their hands and they are writing all what you do. The right hand shoulder, right side shoulder, the angel there writes the good deeds. The left side shoulder, the angel there writes the evil. So these are different pins than that one. نعم والله أعلم.
جزاك الله خير شيخنا. Brilliant reply.
الحمد لله.
حفظك الله.
That last?
أي خلاص.
طيب. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.